Krakus and the Dragon. A long time ago in Poland, there was a village close to the river, Vistula. Near the village, there was a deep, dark cave on the side of a hill. The hill was called Wawel, pronounced Vavel Hill. The villagers believed that a terrible dragon slept in this cave. They did not venture near the cave for fear they would wake the dragon and provoke his anger. They had never encountered a dragon before, but they had heard that dragons that lived in caves were the most dangerous dragons of all. However, there were six young men in the village who doubted that the dragon existed. Not one of the villagers had ever reported seeing or hearing a dragon. Maybe, they thought, the story of the dragon was just a foolish superstition. They decided to inspect the cave for themselves. So one night they made torches and set off secretly to climb Vavel Hill. When they arrived at the entrance to the cave, they peered in nervously. It was pitch black and eerie. Lighting their torches, they entered cautiously. Immediately, a most disgusting odour filled their nostrils and they began to feel sick. They then heard the sound of noisy breathing and felt the air grow hot. Panic-stricken, they turned and ran as fast as they could out of the cave. They kept running until they reached the bottom of the hill. Only then did they dare to look up towards the cave. To their horror, they saw a raging green dragon with huge wings and a long, scaly tail. He was standing at the entrance to the cave, his red eyes flashing in anger. Orange flames flared from his mouth. He stamped a short distance down the hill and lifted up a cow with his strong talons. He disappeared back into the cave, carrying the cow. The youth stared in shock. They knew they should have listened to the warnings of the older people in the village. They should never have gone near the cave. From then on, the fearful dragon emerged daily to feed on the cattle and sheep that grazed on the hillside. The villagers realized there was only one way to stop the dragon. He would have to be killed. Some of the men in the village armed themselves with sharp axes and waited at the cave entrance for the dragon to appear. When the dragon came out, the men dug their axes into the dragon's body. The axes did not harm the dragon because his body was protected by thick scales. The villagers decided to ask Krakus for his help. Krakus was a wise man in the village who healed people with mixtures of herbs. Krakus said he would help the villagers to get rid of the dragon. He made a very special paste and rubbed it on a sheep. Then he led the sheep up the hill and left it at the entrance to the cave. A short time later, the dragon stormed out of the cave and devoured the sheep. Immediately, the dragon felt a terrible burning in his stomach. This was caused by the special paste that Krakus had used. The dragon charged down the side of the hill to the river Vistula and began to drink. He gulped and gulped the cool water, but the red hot burning in his inside would not go away. He continued to drink and his stomach became more and more swollen. Suddenly, there was a loud bang as he exploded. At last, the dragon was dead. The villagers were overjoyed. They could get back to their peaceful lives once more. They made Krakus their leader and built a castle for him at the top of Wawel Hill. He was a good ruler and the community thrived. When Krakus died, the people gave him a great burial. They built a huge mound over his tomb on Vavel Hill. You can still see the mound on Vavel Hill when you visit Krakow in Poland.